Hey, what up? This is Eddie04, and I'm quite sure that you have watched my PS4 controller video on playing Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4. Now, today, we'll learn how to do that with our Nintendo Pro Controller. Hey, what up, beautiful people? So, as mentioned before, we're gonna go ahead and set up our Nintendo Pro Controller into PC. So I made a combination of different drivers just to figure out which one was the best way to set up the Nintendo Pro Controller with your PC. And I have a cocktail of drivers, to be honest. I already removed them all because I want to make this tutorial as easy as possible to follow through, and which is the best way to get your Nintendo Pro Controller working with your PC. Now, I know, you know, there's a combination of other things. I have done other videos about setting up your controller, your gamepad, with your PC, and I usually recommend using the Xbox 360 controller emulator, but in this case, it's not the solution for this one. Now, I know I've researched, I read a whole bunch of articles and forums, and I noticed that some of them might recommend using the Xbox 360 controller emulator for the Nintendo Pro Controller, but in my case, it didn't even respond to my inputs from the controller. Even though it detected the controller, it just didn't respond to any of my actions. So I'm gonna show you what was the process of getting together your Nintendo Pro Controller working on PC for any game available. Okay, so let's go ahead. So the first thing is, obviously you need to have your Nintendo Pro Controller, and I'm using actually the original supported cable from Nintendo itself, which usually comes with all the game controllers. If you don't have the cable, you can actually check the description below, and I have a couple of links there that you could use to get either the controller or the Nintendo official cable. So, as mentioned before, the only thing you need to do is go ahead and plug in the Pro Controller with the official Nintendo USB cable. Most likely other cables could work as well, any other third-party cable, but I recommend using them because Nintendo is kind of picky anyways, right? I mean, as you can see, right, the main reason why the Nintendo Pro Controller doesn't work with Windows is because there's no, I guess, official driver for the Nintendo Pro Controller for Windows. So Windows actually detects the controller. Right now I just plugged it in, so I'm gonna go ahead and open up Windows, and I'm just gonna type in controller, for example, and it's gonna ask me to set up my controller. As you can see, it already says Pro Controller, which is the right thing to do. Actually, it detected the controller, but if I go to properties, you will notice that right now, even though it has been detected as the Pro Controller, it's not really taking any input that I press. So that means that right now, there's no way to translate whatever input is coming into the game controller and going into Windows, but he knows that there's a USB device connected to Windows. So what we need to do, and I believe that this is the best way of solving it, is actually getting one of the platforms that handle the drivers, and they have been adding new features to their platform to be able to control different setups or different controllers that you're gonna be using. In this case, I know, you should go ahead and use the Steam software. Now, even though your game is not in Steam, you can still use this method because it allows you to set up the Pro Controller on Windows, and you can use it for anything. Now, the reason why this works is because it kind of takes the Nintendo Pro Controller as if it was a Steam controller. It actually uses the analog sticks as if it was a mouse to be able to move and control mouse and tabs within your computer. So we're gonna go ahead and close this out. Right, I'm gonna leave the properties there just for a minute, and we're gonna load up Steam. Now on Steam, we wanna go to Big Picture. You can usually do right click on the Steam icon and just click it on Big Picture, or you can go to your library, and in the upper right corner where it says the little square here, you're just gonna go ahead and click on Big Picture mode. Now when Big Picture mode is loaded, remember, the Nintendo Pro Controller wasn't responding, but because you open up Steam, it automatically takes the inputs. And this is because Steam has set up a way that he will detect a USB device that is a controller to send instructions or inputs into their platform. In this case, we're gonna go ahead to the little gear and go to settings, go to controller settings, and now guess what? You'll notice that there is a detected controller, which is the Nintendo Pro Controller, and you can actually enable the Switch Pro Controller configuration. This configuration will enable or will send all the inputs from the controller into Windows, making it from a D input into an X input. Just turn that on, and you'll notice also that there's a new setting which says use Nintendo button layout. Now that depends, that's actually about your preference. So currently, you know that the Xbox 360 controller has similar buttons, similar to the Nintendo Switch controller, the X, the Y, the A, and the B. Just that their layout and positioning is a little bit different, and the way that it behaves or reacts is slightly different. So in this case, by going here, you will notice that they're just showing you the changing or the swapping of controllers layout. So pretty much what would happen is that your A is gonna work differently from your B as you would regularly use on your Xbox controller. After this, just go ahead and press B on your Nintendo Pro Controller, and that's about it. Now I'm gonna go ahead and tap into the properties just to show you that now, even though I didn't change anything else, I just went ahead and enabled the Nintendo Pro Controller support. And now when I go to properties, you'll notice that in the test tab is already taking in some kind of inputs. Now I know it looks a little bit crazy, but it's because he's also taking the gyroscope as well as any kind of additional movement from my gamepad. And as you can see, as I mentioned, now by using my right stick, it's taking it as if it was a mouse, and my left stick would also do some additional inputs in Windows. With this done, pretty much that's about it. You just need to go ahead and click on OK, close this out, and let's go ahead and test it out. So I'm gonna go and play Naruto Ninja Storm, which is the same game that I've been using for testing all the different gamepads that I've been using, and it's really straightforward. Now the only tricky part here is that the button layout is going to be a slightly different, so if you're used to playing the game in a certain way, then you might want to disable that Nintendo Pro Controller layout so that it can work the same way as an Xbox controller. One of the main tests that I do as soon as I load the game, if I can press something and it will actually exit out of the intro, then we're good. About this, just press A, and I'm gonna go ahead and try to fight a game. Yeah, buttons are totally different. It just feels a little bit off. But besides that, everything else is okay. Okay, I kind of got him. Okay, so that's about it. Pretty straightforward. Actually, just need to use the Steam app and connect your Nintendo Pro Controller, set it up a little bit, and that should be able to work with any game. If I go ahead and exit out of the Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm game, and I'm gonna exit out of Big Picture, I can still use my Nintendo Pro Controller as if it was a mouse. And this can work for any other game outside of Steam. Hey, hope you liked the video. Go ahead and hit the thumbs up if you liked it. Also, subscribe to the channel to watch more videos like this. And don't forget to click on the notification bell to be notified whenever I release a brand new video. By the way, you can go ahead and watch how I did this with the PS4 controller up here. Or you could also watch my playlist down here. This was Eddie04. See you on the next one.